and I'm joined by the reality star from The Real World Las Vegas, and she was also on MTV's Battle of the Exes competing with her current boyfriend, Dustin. She also has video blogs that you can find on YouTube, and she has a jewelry business found on Etsy.com. And so here is Heather Marter. Hi, Heather. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. So thank you for coming on the program. And how did you first end up auditioning for The Real World?
It's actually kind of funny. I first auditioned, it's really a long process. It's a process over a few months. There's like six different parts to it. And the first one I ended up going to was an open call in Philadelphia. And I happened to just be home from college that weekend. And I was a TV production major in college, so I was kind of thinking, you know, maybe, like, I can go and get some background experience. I was thinking of possibly going the route of being a casting director. So it was really, I mean, I never really thought that I was going to make the show, so I was kind of doing it for different reasons. And then as I kept getting callbacks to the different, phases of the audition process is when I kind of, like, turned around and I was like, oh, okay, so I might actually be doing this.
So this was more of a spontaneous decision to end up furthering your career after college.
Right. I mean, I was always kind of, you know, thinking of things I could put on my resume, doing different things in school, and that it was kind of along the lines of that. I was more just, you know, I was like, oh, well, if I ever go to, you know, a job interview in the future, I can kind of be like, yeah, you know, I went to this thing, I did some background research, you know, I saw how casting directors, you know, the process of the things that they go through, and kind of use an in that way. I never really thought that I would make it on the show.
So once you made it on the show, what were some of the things that were your initial thoughts walking into the house that first day?
I mean, the whole thing is really overwhelming, and it's not like you can really have a ton of expectations just because it's something that's so different, and then, I mean, a lot of people really don't get to experience. So I kind of just, you know, they put you in a hotel the night before, and then you move into the house that next day, and it's kind of just so overwhelming that you really don't know what to expect, but you kind of just get thrown into the situation, and they don't even, like, it's not even like you have time to kind of sit back and you know, like, think, like, how am I going to react? Like, it's very fast. Like, it's just boom, 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 you're in the house. They don't, like, brief you. They don't tell you exactly what's going to happen. They literally throw you in, and there's cameras around, and you just kind of have to react naturally.
Now, as soon as you had found out, were you allowed to tell your family and your friends, or did you have to keep it a big secret until you left for Las Vegas?
Well, when you first find out, you know, they don't really want you to tell many people. My family did know just because at the time, like, I was in college, but I had to, you know, take a semester off, and I kind of had to, you know, like, get my get everything together and stuff. So, I mean, it was kind of inevitable that some people were going to know, but I really didn't tell that many people. And, I mean, I think when I was leaving, only maybe my roommates and my parents knew.
Okay, and how does being on The Real World differ from being on The Challenge? Because I know you and Dustin, your current boyfriend, were both on The Battle of the Exes that is now airing.
Right. I mean, it's a whole different ball game because in the show, you know, everyone's kind of on the same playing field. Like, it's almost like you're that freshman in college and you don't really know anything, so you all get thrown in together, and it's kind of just you reacting naturally and you know, living your everyday life. And so it's very different from The Challenge, where you're kind of thrown in with a bigger group of people, some who've been doing this for a very long time. So it's kind of like all different ends of the spectrum and all different kinds of personalities and more personalities, which makes it even more intense. And also there's that competitive edge and the fact that you're competing for a lot of money that makes, you know, kind of like the demons of some people emerge as well. So, I mean, I know for me, I'm so glad that I got to experience The Real World before getting thrown into a challenge, because I think that having to get used to all the cameras being around and having to get used to, like, that side of things while getting thrown into this competitive part of it would have been extremely overwhelming. Like, I commend the fresh meat people who just get thrown into it all at one time. Like, I don't know how they don't go nuts.
And now, when you were on The Challenge, you guys had an unfortunate situation and had to get sent home. So what exactly happened with that?
That was so depressing. Well, the way that it happened was, I'd like to say that it was like something crazy or it happened in a challenge, but he literally got hurt walking up some stairs. It was just you know, everything was wet outside. It rained off and on. There was, like, dew and moss and stuff. And he just was walking upstairs, maybe skipping upstairs. I don't know. We were watching him. It wasn't anything crazy. He wasn't, like, jumping, like, doing flips or anything. He was literally walking upstairs and fell. And the stairs were made of kind of, like, these slits of rock. And he literally just fell and hit his knee on it. And it sliced to the bone. And they had to send us home. And I think it was more, you know, an insurance thing because they didn't want it to get the water that we were doing some of the challenges in was dirty, and I guess, you know, they were taking the risk of it getting infected. And so although it wasn't, you know, the worst injury that's been on the challenge, it was, like, significant enough, I guess, that I had to send us home.
So now I do remember them saying something about since you didn't have any other exes on the shows, they had to send you home with him. Whether you did or not, would they have still sent you home?
You know, I think that with the whole thing with Sarah and Vinny that just happened where they had to send her home with him, I think it would have been extremely controversial if they kept me and let me, you know, stay with a different partner. And the thing is, even if they had brought in, you know, like, anyone that I had kissed, like Mike, I don't think that I would have wanted to stay anyway. I think that there was a really good dynamic going on between me and Dustin, and I think that, you know, we were really enjoying having this experience together, and I would have felt bad kind of just like staying with a different partner.
And now you are also known to a lot of people for making video blogs on YouTube as well as making your own jewelry. So how did you get into making your own jewelry and selling it?
So I actually had, unfortunately, my mom's great aunt passed away, and she had, you know, all of this great vintage jewelry. And I've been into the vintage and jewelry scene for a little while. Like, I really like, you know, finding vintage stuff, like whether it be clothes or accessories or whatever. And so I thought it'd be really cool to kind of start compiling things with, you know, vintage stuff that I got from my mom or vintage stuff that I got from her great aunt, and even stuff that I found on my own, and kind of like making cool pieces, because I've always had a kind of creative and artistic side, and I've really, you know, been enjoying it and putting it up, and other people seem to be responding good to it. So it's been really fun. And with the videos, I was a TV production major, and I really love editing and putting, like, pieces together, video pieces together. So me and Dustin kind of got a camera in the mail from MTV, like a little Cisco video camera, and we started just making videos one day, and I started editing them, and I was like, we should really put this up on YouTube and, like, see, you know, whoever follows us on Twitter will probably, like, enjoy seeing kind of a different side to us that they maybe got to see on the show. So we just started that, too, and I've really been enjoying both, doing both. I think that it's been a lot of fun, and it's kind of, you know, let me be a little creative and let me do things that I didn't really necessarily get to do all the time.
Now, with the jewelry, how would you describe your pieces?
I would say that they're very, like, a compilation of vintage and kind of a little bit of modern. I've been doing some keychains, too, which are steampunk-inspired, and I take watch movements and Swarovski crystals and different little trinkets that I find and little vintage parts, and I put them together. And those have been really popular. But the necklaces are more simple. They're just vintage pieces, and I'll either add something, or if I think that they're beautiful already, I'll just, you know, like, kind of change it and change the look a little bit. So that's been really fun for me to kind of, you know, get to delve into my creative side.
Okay. And now, do you have anything else coming up besides working on these videos and working on your jewelry?
For now, I think I'm just, you know, taking things one step at a time. I'm trying to find a full-time job. I've been helping out, you know, at a vintage store, which has been fun. But I'm kind of just, you know, waiting, just seeing what the next step of my life is going to be. Kind of not taking it too seriously, not, like, over-planning anything for once, and just kind of seeing what happens.
So if you got the chance to go on another challenge, would you?
Right now, I don't have plans to do anything else on TV. If anything, I would hope to do something behind the scenes. So right now, I'm just kind of, you know, seeing my options work-wise and trying to establish a career.
Well, that's really cool. And thank you for coming on the program, Heather.
Thank you so much for having me.
It was a pleasure talking with you.
It was nice talking to you, too.
That was Heather Marter. She is from The Real World Las Vegas and MTV's Battle of the Exes. If you are interested in checking out any of her video blogs, you can look them up at youtube.com/HeatherMarter. And for her jewelry, if you're interested in purchasing any of that, it's at Etsy.com. And that is /shop/HeatherMarter. She has some very creative pieces up. I have pictures of several of them. One is a circle with it looks like a diamond cross in the middle, and then black stones filled in the circle around that. Another, it looks like there's an animal in the center of a clock kind of piece. She's one-of-a-kind pieces. I don't think I've seen any piece that looks absolutely identical. So if you were to order this, then you would have a one-of-a-kind Heather Marter piece.